stronger than the knife, and they can kill it once, but they can't kill it twice.
What? Straight gate. Straight gate. How? Unity's number one. That's all we need. All you need, they cutting back on everything. That's the hit you. Colleges, welfare, Medicaid, Medicare. They're gonna hurt you. And you're gonna lay down and take it like a little baby. All you have to do, the greatest resources in the world, you have it, and that's unity. What the hell are you scared of? What's the matter with you people? All right, call them sign up. This is your worst enemy right here. You gotta straighten this out before we can make a move. Call the tribes out, brother.
Judah.
Huh? All right. Judas, the so-called Negro. Who's that? Benjamin, the so-called West Indian. Levi, so-called Haitians. Simeon, Dominica, Zebulun, Guatemala to Panama, Ethan, Puerto Ricans, Manessa, Cuban, Gad, North American Indian, Reuben, Seminole Indians, Naphtali, Argentina, Asha, Colombia, Issachar, the Mexican. That's it. That's your family. Now, why you ain't together? What's your problem? Puerto Rican's over here talking about he Puerto Rican. Don't fool with the Negro. Negro is telling the Cuban telling the Puerto Rican, don't fool with him. Huh? What the hell is the matter with you people? You're the same people. Damn it. Unless your father among the Puerto Ricans, if your father's a white man, a gringo, then you ain't part of that nation. Damn right you ain't. You're Puerto Rican, you're a white man. But if you're of Indian descent, Negro descent, and you're part of us, brother. Bible said let the chaff and the wheat grow together. After a while, we're going to separate this. What are you going to do then? Huh? The Lord said Puerto Rican and the other tribes would go out and mingle with the devil. Bring children in the world for the devil. You think because your hair's straight and you got that little yellow color that you're better than we are? No. Hell no. Everything come from darkness.
That's right.
Light came out of darkness.
That's right.
What's the matter with you people? Huh? What's the matter with you? I'm light. I'm better than you. That's a damn lie. You so much, if you so-called yellow people, and you got your father the white man, and you so much better than we are, then get in there and whoop Mike Tyson. The strongest people in the world, the black people, man. You know that?
Yeah.
When a white woman want her man, she don't go get the Puerto Rican there. She go looking for a black man. A strong man, brother. Yeah, she know what's happened. She know what to get. Yeah, you black men are the people. You act like, I'm so scared. I'm in fear. You ain't in fear of no damn body. Nobody. The other tribes, the books ain't gonna raise the tents of Judah first. He gonna think Judah's the one paving the way around here. Where's all your ball players? All your fighters? Athletes? All of them is who? Black boys. Look at O.J. Simpson. Huh? So wake up. But if we all come together, we're like a bed of roses. We unite that strength together, then we can get somewhere. Huh? Let's wake up, brother. White man don't care how yellow you look. If you, to him, you're a nigger, that's all. He throw you in the same pot we're in, damn it. Now the question is, when are we going to stop this foolishness? Huh? I'm talking to you. White man's smarter than all of you. He throw all of you in the same pot up there in the Bronx. But yet you try to segregate yourself against the Negro or the Haitian or the Levites or the other tribes. I mean, what's the problem? After a while, we're going to have an army. And either you're going to be for that nation or we're going to pull your heads off. Give a damn if you're Puerto Rican, a Negro, or a Porsche, or Indian, or who you are. If you ain't for the cause, you ain't with the nation, then you got to die. Just quick as that. We that's right, brother. There's a lot of mess, man, going on here among these 12 tribes. White man don't want none of you. That's why he's using genocide against you. He don't give a damn about you. That's why he's cutting off the welfare, Social Security, Medicaid, college tuition, you name it, he's cutting it off. And it ain't gonna affect nobody but you. And you run around and laughing in this cracker's face talking about your friend. He's no friend of yours. He's your number one enemy. He's got everything. He ain't giving you nothing. He won't even create no jobs for you. He ain't create no jobs for you. We have to come together and create our own jobs. We can do it. 50 of you walking down to the city hall, he laugh at you. But let 1 million of you walk down now. 1 million of you. Then he'll talk to you. Now, we're going in the scripture and show you some things in the scripture, but I want to let you know, first of all, our first problem is we ain't together. There's 2.5 million of our people in New York. If we were to get $1 a week, or $5 a week, brothers, we couldn't have our own lottery. How was the white man his lottery? You ain't winning nothing out of that, no way. That money's supposed to be given to the schools. Look at the condition the schools is in. Girls getting raped. Toilets leaking, holes falling down in there. Holes in the bathroom. Halls is dark. 40, 50 kids in one class. See, and you go along with that. It's time we set up our own school. You don't need a white man to take you by the hand and lead you to the bathroom. Tell you what you have to do. Wake up! Waking up time, brother. The Arabs is woke. Koreans is woke. The Japanese is woke, and they had war with them. And had them beat down, man. Every nation, the Germans, they had war with them. Look at the Germans today. The only one lagging is our people is lagging. And damn it, it's time to wake up. Get up off your knees and stop begging the white man for his damn crumbs. Ain't you sick of that mess? Where's your businesses down here, Sean? Point them out to me. Where they at? Look all around. Where's your business? You know, I'm not for no whorehouses, but you guys don't even have them down here. Where's a nice old house down here? You don't even have that. That's bad. That's bad. You could get some of them white girls and peddle them down here. What's wrong with that? Them old bronze and blue eyes and redheads. Yeah, some Chinese, Japanese, Koreans. Yeah, you can get all them old funny looking women and put them down here. Make good money, man. So what's your problem? Don't put no sisters down here now. Yeah, don't, but you want to sell drugs? Don't sell them to your people. Sell them to the white people. Chinese, Japanese, they're buying it. Go on Wall Street down there, all them bunch of dope addicts down there. I'm talking about them white people. Yeah, they're real freaks. Catch them at lunchtime out there, man. They'll give you $100 for what you get them hauling $5, pay $5. See, you don't like that though, do you? The hell's wrong with them white people? They're your enemy, man. They exploit the hell out of us. 250 years they worked us for nothing. What I care about them now? They're my enemy. They're my enemy. But our women, we love them. Set up clinics, take care of women, our children. Do whatever we have to do to get the money and do things for our men. You guys go out there and rob a bank for your drugs. But you can't rob a bank to help your people, can you? Some of you guys support a habit, $1,000 a day, $500 a day. When it comes to getting money in here to help our people set up a home welfare, oh, you don't know how to do that, though, do you? See what I'm talking about, people? And I'm going to show you this. I'm going to show you how the Lord compares us with the two dumbest animals in the world. Get out of here. Now, I didn't compare you to them. The Most High compared you to the two dumbest animals in the world, the ox and the ass. But one thing about it, we don't have to remain dumb. They picked to cut out college tuition so you can't even get the little education you've been getting. Then when you go to apply for a job, well, you're not qualified. They had in the paper a few weeks ago, they had a code they were using. What was the code? I'm listening. Damn, you guys don't even read the newspaper. The code was 23. You go to get a job, all they got to do is put on your application, 23. Or to buy a house, 23. That means you're a Negro or Puerto Rican or West Indian or something. So you're Indian, so you don't get the house, you don't get the car or the money, the loan, $100,000. They dump in the waste basket. Puerto Rican, West Indian, Cuban, 23. Oh yes, if we don't take care of you, you will call you soon. You have a very good chance of getting this place, of getting this $100,000. No, he's lying. Oh, you go home with honey. I think I'm going to get it. Yeah, you get it all right. Yeah. Yeah, you get it. You don't get nothing. Okay, we're going to read these scriptures for you now. I wanted to talk to you and tell you these things because I want you to see where our problem lies. See, if you don't find out the problem, you can't do a damn thing. Our biggest problem is unity. We don't come together. You understand? Yeah, come on. All right, we're going to read. Yeah.
Isaiah, the first chapter, verses 2 and 3. Hear, O heavens, and give ear, O earth, for the Lord has spoken. I have nourished and brought up children, and they have rebelled against me.
See what the Most High nation did? Yeah.
This damn cracker-ass woman come up here, so-called Jew, talking about the Sabbath. I told her, we're teaching the law. This is the law that we're teaching. And I say, furthermore, you so-called white people ain't none of you Jews. The so-called Negroes are real Jews. And you devils that's using our name, when it come time to take the white world down, we're going to kill your ass first. Your ass going to be put to death first. You ones that run around talking about you Jewish because you taking our name and dragging it in the dirt because you ain't no Jew. The real Jews are the so-called Negroes. All you devils come out of the seed of Esau. That's who you are. You're not the children of Jacob. You're the children of Esau.
That's right. Prove that in Revelation. Oh, what you got now?
1 and 2.
All right, a whole lot in that. Let's prove who the Jews are. You so-called Negroes are the original Jews by nature. The white man ain't no Jew. Who is he? He's the devil. He's in counterpart of Satan. You the devil's children, just like we the Most High's children. Look how the white man came here in the shores of America and stole the country from the so-called Indian. And where did he put him? On the reservation. And he brought you here and put you in what? Slavery. Made you pick his old cotton and work for him for 15 years. But there's one thing, Whitey, you forgot. There's payback. We're going to put your butt in the cotton field. We're going to take your women and we're going to ravish them. What you going to do then? Just like you pay back. Kill your dream like you sow.
That's right.
Your woman's gonna become the new aunt, your mama on the pancake box.
Daddy.
I can see you turning red now, but you're gonna mop them floors.
That's right.
You're gonna mop them floors,
yeah,
yo. Yes. Okay. Well, we're gonna read this. Show you that they're not a Jew. It's in your Bible. It's in your Tanakh. It's in your Tanakh.
Jeremiah 14:2. Revelation 2:9. I know thy work and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
All right, start over again. I'll tell you when to start.
I know thy work and tribulation and poverty.
Hold it. Now, he's talking about this nation here. He knows your tribulation. He knows your poverty. Because you black people in the ghettos and eat for Puerto Rico and so forth, you the ones have problems. Can't hardly pay your rent. Don't know where the food's coming from. Gotta go kiss the white man behind to get a job and make money. So they're not Jews. Don't ever let them tell you they're Jews. They're from the seed of Esau. And the counterpart of Satan, they are the devil's children.
And these devils walking around here taking pictures, these so-called Jews, like they didn't like what he was saying. So he's going to take a picture of them. Hey, so-called white man, the Most High, God and the angels and Jesus Christ is taking your picture. Taking your CIA, your FBI, your president, your Navy, your Air Force, your Army, your space probes, and all that garbage gonna be blown to hell and back. Because you devils are coming down. Christ and the angels gonna bring you down. Along with he gonna cause the spirit, the Most High, whom you call God, gonna cause the spirit of the so-called Negroes, West Indian, Puerto Ricans to rise up against you so-called white people all throughout your system. The ones in the government gonna turn against you so-called white people. The ones in the Navy, the blacks in the Navy, so you can understand. I'm going to speak clear English. Going to turn against you whites in the Navy. The blacks in the Air Force going to turn against the whites in the Air Force. The blacks in the police department going to turn against the white policemen. The black FBI going to turn against the white FBI. The black CIA going to turn against the white CIA. That's going to be all throughout the system, and you bastards going to die there. And you ain't going to be holding your arms all folded like you bad. You faggots ain't bad. You're a bunch of faggots. We can't wait to kill your stupid faggot ass. We can't wait to put your asses to death. And you're going to die in America. That's from one end of America to the other end of America. Your blood going to run like water. I'm talking to you white faggots. That's who I'm talking to. You and your president, you and your FBI, you and your CIA, you and your Marines, you and your Air Force, you're going to die.
That's right.
That's right, you green berets. We're going to get you first.
That's right.
We know all about you. They got concentration camps for us. But you're going to end up getting your butt put in a concentration camp.
And the high priest is right to kiss out that tape. The Panama deception, when Bush sent the Marines down in Panama to kill Noriega, they butchered and slain over 7,000 of our people down there, man.
That's
these guys back there, these Marines back there, a bunch of criminals, man. A bunch of criminals and murderers and gangsters over there. You, that's right, you. Give you us there.
Hey, and the West Indians, the Puerto Ricans, the Central Americans, the South Americans, they ain't forgot about none of this.
You're going to be fighting the whole, you're going to be fighting the Indians off the reservation, you're going to be fighting the Mexicans, you're going to be fighting the Haitians, you're going to be fighting the Negroes, you're going to be fighting all the so-called blacks in this country, you're going to be fighting your so-called white people. Ain't going to be no damn joke then. When they had the riot in California, they were scared to death. You so-called white people scared to death in America. You send your damn National Guards down there without bullets. Without bullets in their guns. That the Most High wanted to take your ass off then. He would have took your ass off then.
Right.
Hey, when it's wake-up time, blacks got all kinds of weapons out here in the street. America. Let me name the list that's going to be fighting you so-called white people. The Colombians, the Mexicans, the Cubans, the Indians off the reservation, the Negroes, the West Indians, the Puerto Ricans, and they got all kinds of weapons out there. You dumb, stupid-ass white people. When it comes time to kill you, they're going to kill you like water from a fire hydrant at full speed. And you ain't gonna be looking dumb and simple like you are now. And you Uncle Tom niggas, they gonna kill your ass too when that time comes. You Uncle Tom Latin Americans, they gonna kill your ass at that time when that time comes. You Uncle Tom West Indians, the ones that's rising up, gonna kill your simple ass when that time comes. And I'm glad that time is coming.
A lot of you brothers gotta see that tape, man. A lot of you missed this thing back in 92, 93 when President George Bush sent the American Army in Panama. You bastards, you Marines, you Navies, you're a bunch of criminals, man. You're a bunch of blood-sucking, thirsty dogs. And when the time comes, we're going to kill you, man.
Right.
In whose name? In God's name and Christ. Your Marines are a bunch of faggots.
Right.
Your Army are a bunch of faggots. Your police force are a bunch of faggots. And when the time comes, God is going to give us the power to kill you devils, man.
This ain't no idle talk, because the Spirit of the Most High got this thing working. You got blacks that's been in the army that know about blowing up, that know about explosives, that been trained to kill, that's out here in all different kind of groups. You so-called white people is in so much damn trouble, you don't realize how much trouble you're in. You walking around on borrowed time. They're going to go in your neighborhood and kill you. You think you're safe in your neighborhood. They're going to go in your house and kill you. They're going to enter into your neighborhood and kill you. When the God rise them up in this land, when God rise the black man up in this land, you ain't going to be able to call 911. 911 going to be getting killed. They're going to be busy getting killed. This thing going to be serious then.
That's right. Last week, an ex-soldier had a tank. How about that? Now, all you need a tank and put some ammunition in it, you can do much damage.
Yep.
And all these concentration camps they built for us, they got 18 of them.
Yeah.
They better watch it. Damn, they'll be the ones going in concentration camps. That's why I'm telling you blacks, you got to get it together. They're working on you now.
That's right.
You're around here galley dancing and laughing, they're going to lock you behind up in the concentration camp. But if we come together, we can beat all this mess.
Right.
It's serious business now. All right, now we're going to read what we're reading here.
Revelation
2:9-3:9, to prove to the world that they're not the Jews. You Negroes walking around here with false identities and IDs, you're the original Jew by nature. I'm a Negro. I'm black. What the hell is black? Huh? All them funny colors. Return back your true nationality. You are a Jew out of the nation of Israel. Now read it, brother. Revelation 2:9. I know thy work and tribulation and poverty. But thou art rich. Yes, you're rich because your father's rich. But you don't return to your father. You go run into the white man for his welfare, his handout. I'm glad he's cutting it out. That's going to make you come together. And all you black bucks around there got the white man out here feeding your family. You're going to learn to feed your own family. Don't say you can't do it. Hell, I fed mine. I didn't go around begging nobody. I was working, took care of my family. And raised them up, sent them to school. Made men and women out of them. And that's what you men are going to have to do. Show that your responsibility, damn it. Lead on.
And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not.
Who is it always calling themselves Jewish? Adding the ISH under their name. Meaning wishing they were pertaining to. Like you could say you're blackies. You're whiteies. You're yellowies. See? Something wishing something pertaining to, but not the original by nature. Damn it. Take back what rightly belongs to you.
That's all I'm telling you.
Blessed are the synagogues of Satan.
See there, see what the Most High said? They are of the synagogue of who? Of Satan. Satan is who? The devil. Now, dare you go out and talk about he's Jewish. You're the Jew. You're the Jew. That's why things is happening to them over there. The headstones, the graveyards, the synagogue, because they're not right. Got you walking around talking about, I'm Negro. I'm Puerto Rican. I'm West Indian. I'm Cuban. All them labels on that sign. Like you label a piece of meat, dog, cat. All that. You're happy being that. You're going to wake up, brother. It's your time now. This is in your generation. It ain't my generation or back there. No. Now, I'm 70. It wasn't in my generation. It's in your generation, damn it. So wake up and get this thing set right. You're going to do it, too. Or you're going to catch hell out here in these streets. Ain't enough of you laying out in these streets yet. Your family's crawling, eating out of garbage cans like they're doing in the islands now. In Mexico, Cuba, they're down there eating out of the kids I'm talking about. Eating out of garbage cans. That's soon to come here, you know that? Then you're going to wake up. Go knock on the white man's door. Can I have a piece of bread? Get out of my face, nigga. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. That's right.
They want you so-called blacks to die, and you're jiving around. They're saying cut the Medicaid, cut hospital care. They don't want nobody coming to your house. They want you to die this time because they say the drugs ain't working fast enough. So now they say, we're going to cut off everything. So them prophecies, what's going to happen is the prophecies that the Most High got lined up in the Bible where Israel is going to turn against the system. That's what's going to happen. Like it says in the book of Joel. Like it says in the book of Micah. Give me Micah 5 and 7. You know the one in Joel? Give me that one, too. Micah 5 and 7. And the remnant of Jacob shall be in the midst of many people. The remnant of Jacob is you so-called Negroes, West Indian, Puerto Rican, which is the nation of Israel. Shall be in the midst of many people. The many people that you're in the midst of is the so-called white man, the African, the Arab, the Chinese, all these different nations that's here in America, the melting pot. As a dew from the Most High. As a dew from the Most High. What do that mean? When you look out, when you live out in the country and you look out on the grass and see the dew in the morning, it covers the whole ground. It's wet with water. So the Most High say when he rides you up with that spirit, you so-called Negroes, West Indian, Puerto Ricans, of that war, that race war that's going to be in America, that's going to cover all America before it be destroyed, you're going to be like a dew on the so-called white man, on the Arab, on the Chinese, on the Japanese that's here in America. As the showers upon the grass, when the showers come down, how do they come down heavy? Boo, and they beat on the grass. That tarrieth not for man, that tariff not for man, meaning they ain't gonna send nobody out there to stop you. That means Jesse Jackson, Uncle Tom ain't gonna be able to come out and say, why don't you Negroes stop? Because his ass gonna get killed in that day. That means all the so-called black leaders, none of them is gonna be able to come out and stop you in that day. No waiter for the sons of men. And that group ain't waiting for nobody, so ain't nobody coming out to stop them. And the remnant of Jacob shall be among the nations in the midst of many people. And you're among the nations in the midst of many people. It's talking about in America. As a lion among the beasts of the forest. You ever see Wild Kingdom on TV? All the animals come down in a water hole, and the lions come down there, and they pick out who they want to eat up. Do anybody stop them? Hell no. As a young lion among the flocks of sheep, as a young lion among the flocks of sheep, meaning the
Most High going to take the spirit away from the so-called white man. He's going to break the power of the so-called white man, so he ain't going to be able to do a damn thing against the ones that's rising up in this country when it comes time for them to rise up. Because this is a spiritual thing, you dumb, stupid-ass white people. The angels in Christ is what's going to block your Air Force, your Navy, and your Army so they can't do a damn thing. Chinese, the East Indians that's here in America, gonna get tread down by the Negroes, the West Indians, and the Puerto Ricans. Whoever the so-called Negro, West Indian, and Puerto Rican come on, they're gonna tread them down. Like young lions chasing sheep. What can a sheep do to young lions? And none can deliver. And who's saying this? God. Who's saying this? God. What are we reading the Bible? And the Most High say, ain't nobody gonna stop them. None shall be able to deliver you so-called white people from this destruction that's going to come on you from the black man here in America that you call Negroes and West Indians and Puerto Ricans. They're going to kill your ass, so-called white man. You bunch of faggots, you, because that's what you are, a bunch of faggots.
That's right. Now, we got a sign down here. You know, you heard of reap what you sow?
Yeah.
All right. The white man have sowed all these seeds, and he's going to reap them. Pick up that sign down there, brother. No, this one down here. This one down here. I want to show this brother something. You know, they used to barbecue our people in slavery. Show them the one, and listen, point out the one where they're barbecuing the brother.
Is it on there?
Yeah, it's on there. I saw it. Hold it up high. Give my hand, somebody over here. See that they're barbecuing a black man?
You want to forget all of that, bro?
Walk out there where they really can see, brother. Yeah, give my hand somebody with a sign.
I got it.
All right. You got to go point out where they are. You got another sign? Yeah.
And another thing, they keep making movies about our history that you don't know about, like Braveheart. Braveheart was about us. But now they're mad. They used to make us, when they made history about the Scottish and all that, they used to have them dressed up nice and clean. But now that the truth is coming out, this picture called Braveheart, they got them dressed up like a bunch of bums, man. I'm mad as hell.
I know.
And they got them dirty, their face all dirty, like they never took a bath. That was us. We were clean. We took a bath, and our garments were clean. This damn bastard-ass white man gonna pay for that. This damn bastard-ass devils that run the movie industry, these so-called Jewish Illuminati members, they gonna, Illuminati, gonna pay for that king-size lie and all the lies they're putting out about our people and these movies. Like they made Abraham on TV and they had him dressed up in rags like he's a bum. They're gonna pay for all of that. And they made Jacob and Esau and they had Jacob dressed up in rags like he's a bum. They're gonna pay for that. All these garbage-ass movies that you devils are making, you're gonna pay for that. Braveheart was about us. Sir William Wallace was a black man, a black Jew. During that time, blacks was ruling Europe. And they wasn't dirty and nasty. And they didn't have no, they had undergarments on under there. They had what you call a loincloth wrapped around. They wasn't showing themselves like they did in that movie. They showed themselves, then turned around and showed their butt to the enemy. They wasn't doing that.
No, they wasn't doing that. Now you see how they used to do our people? Get the book called 100 Years of Lynching and read that. Then you'll see what happened back there. It ain't no bygones be let bygones, so all you Uncle Tom niggas that don't want revenge, we're going to take care of you. Now here's another picture here. This country belonged to the so-called Indians. Show them the picture. There's who the country belonged to. They came in, took the country from the so-called Indians, and brought you here in slavery. And you just as happy as a turkey. The hell you got to be happy about?
Homeborn slave.
Yeah, the homeborn slave. You just as happy? Look, there's the rightful owner of this country, so-called Indians. Look at them. Where you got them now? Where they at? On the reservation. And they got concentration camps to put you people in. They got 18 of them in there in this country. And they were going to use them when Martin Luther King was down there in the South, rebelling against this system. Only thing, he didn't go far enough. He got killed. They had sharpshooters following that crowd, ready to shoot him down like a dog. And don't say they wouldn't have done it. Didn't they stick dogs on them people? They put water holes on them. They done every cruel thing in the book to those people because they wanted to vote. And you still ain't got no rights. And we're going to show you where this devil come from, too.
And you lied about every damn thing, because the heroes that you honor was our foreparents. Like I said earlier, we was ruling Europe. We was overthrown in 70 AD by the Greeks and Romans and taken up into the Roman Empire. In 193 AD, we overthrew the Roman Empire and ruled all Europe. That's what they've been hiding. Henry VIII, Queen Elizabeth I, those were black Jews. That movie that they just made called Braveheart, the black people was ruling then. That was blacks fighting against each other. That's how we fell. We had you so-called white people in captivity then. When Mel Gibson made that movie and the guys that he had working on that movie with him, they knew they lied when they showed them dirty and nasty. There wasn't no dirty and nasty people. You're the dirty and nasty people, so-called white people. You're going to pay for that lie. Had them as a little kid like he never took a bath. Then had them as grown men with rags on, with sackcloth on. And they were nobles. You bastards, you're going to pay for these lies that you put out about our foreparents. We know how to dress. We were dressed up during that time. We had beautiful garments. And that your historians and your archaeologists know this. Your movie makers know this. When they made that movie called Robin Hood, Thieves, Robin Hood Thieves of Heart. Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, Robert. Put out by Kevin Costner. They had him dressed up like bums. Had him dressed up like bums in that movie. Hollywood, so-called Hollywood, is going to pay for that, which is run by the so-called Jews. And the Illuminati is going to pay for all these lies they put out about our foreparents. These movies that you be seeing about the heroes and all that, Robin Hood and all, that was our foreparents. The Knights of the Round Table, King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table. They got Richard Gere, damn faggot, playing as Sir Lancelot in the first night. These black people, these so-called white people ain't no first knights. We were the knights. We was King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table. All that history, that's why they was mad with Jeffrey, because they were afraid all of that information come out, because they got the pictures all over the world, all over France, all over England, all over Russia, of who the people were. They were black people. The kings of Europe during that time were black people. Napoleon was overthrowing the royal kings of France, which were black people. And he had Uncle Tom's in his army fighting against their own people to overthrow them with Napoleon. Like the guy that writ Alexander Dumas, that writ the Three Musketeers, he was a traitor. The Three Musketeers that he was writing about were black. D'Artagnan, those were black men. You so-called white people ain't did a damn thing in this earth but be a faggot and a lesbian. That's the only thing your ass did in this earth. You went around and you covered the pictures of the black men and put your pictures up as Henry VIII, as King Louis, and the Louis in France, the Louis family. You did that. But those were black men. Those were black women. Marie Antoinette was a black woman. So you're going to pay for all these lies. You so-called Europeans are going to pay for all these lies that you lied about. And these was Hebrew Israelites. That's why they call them Anglo-Saxons. The word Anglo-Saxon means the angel sons of Isaac. Because there were Jews that was ruling Europe.
right. Now, while we're on this history, we're going to show you something else. All your life, you've been taught that Adam, Christ, and the Madonna were black, was white. Now, there's a picture there of Adam and Eve. See that picture on the other side over there, that dark right there? Look at it. Show it to them out there. Right. So Adam and Eve, walk down a little bit so they can see.
Newsweek magazine.
Yeah, news came out in Newsweek magazine. Showing you the color of cry of Adam and Eve. So why they give you in your churches, huh? A white Madonna and the mother of Christ white. Yeah. Like you said, King Arthur, black. All these writers were black. A white man ain't never been nothing but a thief and a robber and a murder. And a liar. Yeah, he's the father of lies. Okay, that's it, brother. We're going on now. Okay, where are we at now? We told you about Revelation 2:9 and 3:9. Proving to you that the white man is not a Jew. He's the son of Satan. He's the counterpart of the devil. The real Jews is you. And it's time for you to step up and take rightfully back what belongs to you. Prior to 1600, there were no niggers, negroes, Bics, Puerto Ricans, West Indies, black people. These are labels that they pinned on you, and you accept them. You go along with it. Yeah, I'm old Bic, I'm old Puerto Rican, I'm old Negro. Now you want to say you're black. Black only means a Negro, another nigga. The original word means black. That's all it means. You walk around and tell me, I'm black. And I'm looking at all of you out there, and I don't see no black people out there. I see your hair black, but not you. You're different shades of brown. Go in the cosmetic store here and buy some black cosmetics. Hurry up and bring it back here to us. See how foolish that is? See, I want some black cosmetics for my wife. Don't tell it after me. They won't know you're crazy or something. So what are you talking about you're black? You're different shades of brown. I see the brown lady here. I can see her hair is black. So what, woman, let's wake up to reality, brother. I'm a Negro. I'm black. I'm an African. You ain't no damn African either. The Africans got together with the white man and sold you into slavery. They over here every day. See if they mingle with you. Damn it. They don't mingle with you. They go with their own people because they know damn well you ain't no African. And you, I'm an African. And Dingo came over here and you grabbed up $9 million or $10 million and gave him to go over there to help his problem. And when they asked him, he said, well, that ain't my problem. That's your problem. All right, we're going on to read the Bible for you and let you know how wrong you are. Yeah, let you know how wrong you are. Read on now. Revelation 3:9. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. See what the book calls them, all these so-called Jewish people? Damn liars. You ain't no Jew. That's why they tear up your cemeteries. Look at them run now. Yeah, they tear up your cemeteries, breaking in your synagogue, setting them on fire, stealing your Torah. And they're going to run your behind out of there, too. Y'all might choose a Jew. You're a damn lie. You're not a Jew. You from Esau. Seed of the devil. That's who the white man is. All of them are from the counterpart of Satan. We'll show you that here this afternoon. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet and to know that I have loved thee. That's a promise. The Most High said they're going to make them devils come and worship before that nation's feet to know that he have loved us. Thus saith the Lord God, behold, I will lift up mine hand to the Gentiles and set up my standard to the people, and they shall bring
bring thy sons in their arms, and thy daughters shall be carried upon their shoulders.
That's right. In slavery, they're going to bring our children, just like you carry their kids now. See a black woman walking down the street, little white baby in the crib? Well, they're going to do that for you. The president on down. Why? Because they're going to become our what? Our slaves. Our slaves.
And kings shall be thy nursing fathers, and their queens thy nursing mothers.
That's the kings right now. The president, Clinton, Carter, all that bunch, coming back in the reincarnation, and they're going to be our slaves.
They shall bow down to thee with their face towards the earth, and lift up the dust of thy feet. And thou shalt know that I am the Lord, for they shall not be ashamed that wait for me.
Yeah, they're going to lick up the dust off our feet, brother. Literally lick the dust off your feet. We haven't come by here now. We pull our shoes off, the white man get down and lick the dust off. We don't have no problem with the white woman. She likes that anyway. No problem with her. But they're going to do that. Literally lick up the dust off your feet. And they're going to pay homage and recognize you, and they're going to know who the real Jew is. And we get through with them. Now, is that it? Okay, now, what you got here? Okay. Now, you say, why the white man got to go through all these changes? Well, we're going to show you why he has to go through these changes. It's in the Bible. We're not out here just rattling off at the mouth. We prove our facts and theories, brother. Now read and show these people why the white man's going in slavery. There's no way out of it. Like Carter said, we're a bunch of beast BS artists. He's going to find out one day how much BS artists we are. He's going to find out. We get that spiritual power. That guns won't stop it, brother. The tanks won't stop it. Ain't nothing going to stop it. They come out and butt up these damn buildings. Yeah, that faggot up there too, Rush Limbaugh. Yeah, big mouth faggot right there. Get him first. Yeah, bragging, always bragging. He put you all down, man. Yeah, he put you down. Him and old Bob Grant. He said that he'd put you on a ship and take you in the ocean, dump you out there in the ocean. Now we're going to read and show you why they're going to catch hell.
Ezekiel 35:5. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and has checked the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword. In the time of the calamity, in the time that their iniquity had an end. Therefore, as I live, saith the Lord, the Most High, I will prepare thee unto blood, and blood shall pursue thee, since thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee.
All right, we're going to start it again and break it down to you. This is in your Bible. In Ezekiel, the 5th chapter. 35th chapter and the 5th verse. You ought to be writing these scriptures down. Go home and check us out.
Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred.
Right there. Why? Because they have had a perpetual hate against us. White man see you, he hates you. In his mind, he's trying to figure out, this is my enemy, how can I destroy him? That's what's in the white man's mind. And the Lord knew that. That's why he said he had a perpetual hate. White devil ain't never liked you. How many of you guys work for him every day? Do they invite you to go home and have dinner with him? Come on, I can't hear this. All right, then. Well, they're your enemy, man. Number one enemy. Yeah, hold that. We're going to get that too.
And has shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword.
And has shed what? The blood of Israel. How? By the force of the sword. They had on the TV today these brothers that had spent 10, 12, 15 years in the penitentiary and didn't commit a crime. They were framed by the policemen. They were framed, picked, and that's a lot of time. And down there in Texas, the one brother wanted to get restitution. And they told him in the law of the state of Texas, he can't get no restitution. 15 years he spent in the prison and did not. They claim he raped two girls and killed them. And they found out the man that did it came and confessed. Right, yeah. And they had him on death row. They had to let him go. Now, where in the hell is any justice in that? They say, pick up any nigga. He didn't look alike. Lock him up. And you ain't committed a crime. All these things was done to, and they shed innocent blood, our blood, by the sword. You know how these cops jump on a man, beat him to death out in the street? Take him downtown, he dies downtown. Choking to death. Beat him to death. Come on, wake up. You know they're doing it. The Lord talking about that. Yeah. Because you shed the innocent blood of my people, the people of Israel, here's what's going to happen to you people. And you can say, I don't do it, but you're all in cahoots together. Ain't none of you ever stepped forth and said you're going to help get the Indian their country back. All you devils go along with that. All of them, all of them keep them locked up on the reservation. All you keep the blacks in the ghettos. All of you got together and got the concentration camp to put our people in. They got them. Better wake up.